Yo, what's up? What's going on, guys? Welcome to the video and welcome back to the beautiful coastline behind me. I'm a little bit further down the coast than one of the last videos I filmed, but nonetheless, it is an absolutely beautiful spot. I'll show you a little bit more of it during this video. But before we begin, please consider hitting that subscribe button below. The channel has been growing really, really rapidly, and it's just going to continue to grow. So I do landscape and photography videos every single Tuesday, so make sure to subscribe to get that weekly content, which possibly coming out soon might even be more frequent than that. We'll see. Okay, so getting into the video today, I am talking about the Canon R6 right here, and its low light / astrophotography capabilities, and really just what are those like, and how good does it do for astrophotography / low light. So this past week I left the coast and I went into the mountains. It's actually where I filmed the last video, but I also did some more work while I was up there, and I went to a dark sky reserve, which is an absolutely beautiful area. If you don't know what a dark sky reserve is, it's pretty much one of the best places in the entire world to shoot astrophotography. There's not a lot of those left in the world, but there are quite a few in the west coast of the United States, so that's the area that I went to. And I wanted to test out how well does this camera right here, the R6, do in low light / astrophotography. I've already kind of tested the low light capabilities a little bit, but I really wanted to test out how well it did with astrophotography. And in short, I'm absolutely blown away by how well this camera did. I didn't do a comparison of say the R5 or the 6D Mark II versus the R6 for astrophotography or low light like I'd done in previous videos. I pretty much just shot some astro on this R6 and really, really stunned by the results. I already made a video kind of comparing the R5 to the R6, and I went over the first impressions of the R6. So if you haven't seen that, go ahead and hit that right up there. You can go ahead and check that video out after you're done with this one. I'll also leave it down in the description down here below. I actually got some of the absolute best astrophotography shots that I've ever gotten in my entire career, and it was really my first time shooting astro in like a proper setting with the R6, and I'm really, really happy with that. So I kind of want to get into some of the shots. I want to break them down a little bit with you and kind of show you what it looked like and kind of run through the process of what my settings were and what the journey was to get these shots. All of these following images, they were shot on a 35mm Canon EF f1.4. It's pretty much my go-to astro lens. It's a little bit cropped in for normal astro settings, but it's just such a versatile lens. It's probably one of my favorite lenses I've ever owned. So I use it for other things as well. I've used it a lot for travel photography, and it's just a really all-around amazing low-light lens. It works great for landscapes as well. So that'll be another video. I'll get into that more, but just kind of wanted to break down the lens that I used to shoot these following shots. So let's go into the first shot. Maybe I'm getting better at astrophotography, or maybe this camera is just absolutely incredible, or maybe it's both. Usually when I go out and shoot astro, I go out and I shoot like maybe 30 to 50 images, and I'm out there for a couple hours depending on the setting, and I come back and I only have like a couple good ones. And this time I went out and I shot probably like 10 shots, and I was just blown away. They were all really good quality. It was really hard to actually decide which ones were keepers and which ones weren't. There were a couple shots that stood out above others, so those are the ones that I ended up going with. So yeah, I ended up only taking maybe like 10 to 12 shots that entire night I was out there, and I wasn't even out there that long. And even in the back of the camera, that's just one thing I really like on the R6, is you can really kind of like see the quality better than on my 6D Mark II. So yeah, I went out there and I only had to shoot like maybe 12 shots, and they were all pretty much winners. But there was a couple that stood above the rest. So I want to go to the first image I shot. I actually shot this right off of the deck of the cabin that I was staying at. So yeah, the first shot is actually shot from the deck of the cabin that I was staying at over to another cabin. And I'm gonna kind of zoom in to show you this, but just the quality of this blew my mind. I think that the low light performance is outstanding. I'm not gonna go into any of the technical details. I just kind of want to share some images that I got and share my experience of using the R6 under astrophotography. If you'd like me to make a video about how to shoot astrophotography or going into a little bit more of that, happy to do that. Just drop a comment below But this is the first image. Let's go into it. And yeah, let's see this. So there's a light that was silhouetting behind. It was a porch light. Normally I don't do that, but it actually lit up the cabin a little bit, and I was still able to really lock in the stars. And really, really amazed with how this one turned out. I mean, it was really cold, really dark night just a week ago. I think it was around maybe 5 to 10 degrees Fahrenheit out there. So that was another reason I didn't want to stay out doing astro too long. This wasn't like the summer heat that you sometimes get when you're shooting astro. But when we zoom in on that, like the clarity of this image is amazing. It's definitely one of the top 5 astrophotography shots I think I've ever gotten, and it doesn't even have a Milky Way or anything. So that's just such an amazing thing about being in like a dark sky reserve where you can just literally walk outside of the door, set your tripod up on the patio, like deck right there, and just shoot an amazing image like that. So part of that was just being in a dark sky reserve. Also, I think that I'm getting a little bit better at astrophotography as well. And also, I think that the R6 is just amazing, and it's really, really shining with its low light astro photography capability. Okay, so I'm gonna show you the next image here as well. And since I was so pleased with the last image of the cabin, across the little road there, I actually went out around midnight down to a lake, and I used my Photo Pills app to see where the Milky Way was going to be, used a kind of a Google Earth if the Milky Way was going to be in the right position across the lake where it was pretty accessible for me to go, and I found the perfect spot right over these mountains. I mean, it's just like a 10-minute drive from the cabin that I was at, and the location and everything ended up being amazing. It was so dark. And it's almost a little bit scary sometimes when you're out there at night, and there's just complete darkness. You don't know if like a bear is gonna come up or something. Luckily a bear didn't, but you never know. I'm in the deep forest up like 8,000 or 9,000 feet in elevation. So definitely in bear habitat. So I was able to line this image up perfectly. The Milky Way was just going right over the mountain range, and I have a lake to silhouette it a little bit. Again, I'm a little bit cropped in with the 35. It would have been an amazing shot with like a 24, but I'm still really, really pleased with the 35. So let's throw that up on the screen here. And I'm just amazed with the clarity. I'm amazed at the reflection of the stars and a little bit of the Milky Way on the lake there. You get an amazing silhouette of the mountains in the background, and you just get a crystal clear Milky Way. And it's, I mean, just amazing the quality of this camera. I only shot, I think, 5 or 6 images in this location. I shot a couple landscape and a couple portrait, and really, really pleased with the portrait shots because I was able to get a little bit more of the Milky Way in. So yeah, really pleased with that. Just wanted to show you a couple images, and I put the settings up there so you can look at those as well. So just want to give an update. I told you I would do that as I'm using the Canon R6. I want to share a couple images. I'm really, really impressed with the R6. It seems to be an incredibly versatile camera, and you can really just do a lot of things with it. If you're really looking for a video, landscape, slow motion, portrait, I mean, this sports camera, I mean, this does a lot of amazing things. So definitely recommend checking out the R6. Again, I'll leave a link for it right down in the description right there. Also, a lot of you guys ask what lenses I use to film these videos on to get this really quite creamy, milky, buttery smooth background blur, and that is the Canon EF 85mm f1.4, so I'll leave a link for that in the description as well. So yeah, again, just wanted to make a video for you. I'm going to be going out in this next week and filming more of an on-location landscape shot, so I'm going to be getting back into more of the traditional landscape photography that we do on this channel, that I do on this channel, I should say. And I'm really excited for that. I'm going to kind of take you on the journey of me shooting landscape photography, and kind of what I look for, and yeah, kind of just an on-location, a little bit of a vlog. So if you ever have any camera gear questions as far as the Canon R6 or other camera gear for landscape photography, or just some landscape photography questions in general, feel free to drop a comment below. Happy to answer those questions, or maybe I'll even make a video on it. So yeah, I will be going out on an on-location shoot next week, kind of walking you through some landscape photography. Not sure exactly the topic of the video, but it will be centered around landscape photography, and it'll be something really kind of fun and new for the channel. So please, if you haven't already, please consider subscribing to the channel. The subscribe button is right there. I make landscape and photography content every single Tuesday, so subscribe for that weekly content. Go ahead and hit the like button if you enjoyed this video, and hit that share button. Share it with some friends, share it with some family, share it with somebody if you really enjoyed it. So I'm gonna sign off here. There's some bugs that are just absolutely trying to eat me alive, so I'm gonna be taking some more landscape shots kind of around this area, but I kind of need to move around a little bit more. And yeah, thank you guys so much for watching. Hit that subscribe button. See you guys in the next video. Peace.